Good morning, friends. This is the midday update. Now, the idea is for the day. The reason I am coming a bit early is because there are certain things I am noticing. A, from 12:150, you've had a very mild 20-point correction. That to me shows that the supply at 12:150 is not great. B, the financials are outperforming. That means that the downside, which was priced into the banking stocks and other financials, was disproportionate last week. So if the financials, they start to outperform, then you know that gives extra support to the Nifty, and in that sort of a scenario you can easily get above 12,150 as well. Now, yesterday I had pointed out my mistake that I had committed. Now, today, let me tell you the mistake I did not commit yesterday. It was clear by midday that our view of the market was not playing out, and it was a bit unclear because of those extraordinary gaps. So a mistake can be, once you see the market running in one direction, you chase it and get in on the highest possible point. And today in the morning you had a 45-50 point gap down and you get into trouble. So A, we avoided that mistake. B, we waited for the next day, which is today, to find an entry which was much better than yesterday. We went long around this 12,107 on the Nifty futures. While it remains to be seen what happens, but the issue is that you avoided further trouble. See, the mistake is never that your view is incorrect. The mistake is often that you don't back off at the right time and sometimes press on with your incorrect view. So today we have much greater clarity because it appears to be clear that we are probably entering a strong market and one that could go up much further than what people expect today. Yesterday, if we had entered, we would have entered around 12,050. Today, we have entered at 12,100. So, hardly 50 points higher with no extra damage. So, that works in the current situation. Okay, now one of the stocks where I can see interesting action is IndusInd Bank. Because of the telecom related issues, IndusInd Bank got all bashed up, and now in the futures market what gets bashed up comes back equally hard. So I wouldn't be surprised if IndusInd Bank has a sharp rally towards say about 1300 thereabouts, and this is something that can be done with a 20 point type of stop. This is not a recommendation, but you know, just ideas you can look at. Similarly, insurance stocks continue to move up. PSU banks, which had a fairly strong downside, they are moving higher. So now the market seems to be ready for a phase of upswing. You know, sometimes people are giving you wild targets, expecting a trending move. My sense is that if you want to be successful in this phase of the market, which is extremely sideways, and all of a sudden the market turns and, you know, starts moving in the opposite direction, if you are not nimble on your views, you will end up getting stuck. So that way, very important that the sector which has led the market lower often is the sector which leads the market higher also. So A, protect your capital, because don't bank on the market to do that for you. B, this is a market which is driven by short covering and profit booking. So take your hits early. If you, you know, delay them too much, if you think no trend is down, there is no trend. We are in upswings or downswings, and that sort of frame of mind has to be there. Like yesterday, we reevaluated our stance and thought that we should only be on the buy side on declines, and today we did not need a second invitation. You have to be that clear on your view. By entering at 12107, if I use a 100 point stop, chances are there is so much support in between at 12080, at 12050, that the stop will have great difficulty in getting hit. So what I am trying to say, the message is that the market has turned, the financials which are getting hit by all this AGR type news seem to have moved on. Global markets are doing fine. So in this kind of a scenario, you can expect a 200 point move, and that is the ideal kind of situation we are trying to play for most of the time. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.